Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Game 2 of EHome vs. VG Gaming Reborn. This is the grand finals of the Chinese regional qualifiers for TI6. First place getting themselves straight into the main event. Second place will be still going to Seattle, but they'll only be in the wild cards, where that's a fight against the three other wild card positioners from the other regions for the two final spots in TI. I'm Eddie Pixel, I'm joined by Andy, and the draft is well underway. So far, things to note. VG Reborn, they are going to grab themselves that first pick, Terrorblade. EHome, they go with a Kunkka. And this is something that Lanham loves doing, isn't it, Andy? This is Lanham, probably the hero that he's played the most in this regionals.
I wouldn't be shocked.
No.
I mean, it's the Lanham special for sure. I'm kind of curious because, you know, Timbersaw and Kunkka on paper are actually pretty good against TB.
Yeah.
You have a couple of AoE spells between them. You know, Timber can cut through the illusions relatively easy. High burst damage, the ability of catching with X marks a spot into a torrent. You know, it seems like a really solid opening from EHome, but they have a tendency, I think, to pick kind of this, not necessarily all-in, but very early to mid-game focused lineup, and with the addition of the Mirana, it's not really much of an exception. They want to just play a fast tempo game, prevent VG Gaming Reborn from getting to their Blink Dagger Slardar, from getting to that, you know, Terrorblade critical mass, which, to be fair, does come fairly quickly now because of things like Dragonlance. But I really think that Vici Reborn last game showcased the fact that even when things start to go a little bit wrong for them, because during the laning phase, EHome were doing well when they were picking their draw composition, they still understand what their lineup is supposed to do, and they still go for the plays. So I'm kind of thinking, you know, EHome going into this, I kind of figured they would win, and to be honest, my prediction was 3-1. Like, I thought that EHome would kind of just own VG Gaming Reborn.
I did as well. I mean, I think for the that first game, it's just come to show that the VG Reborn, they are as good, and you know, they can take games.
Yeah. No, I was very impressed with
the
poise that they had in game number one and understanding the functionality of their lineup and just executing.
Drow's still there.
Yeah, but you can't pick Drow and TB.
Why not? Let's do it. Mikasa, Drow,
that's
Let's
insane,
go.
Because then you'd have to put, like, either one of those two heroes mid lane, and it just becomes, like, this super
Drow versus Timber mid. You could do that, couldn't you?
I mean, you could, but unfortunately, you don't have the access to the Beastmaster, which I think is something else that you really want if you're going to be running that strategy. You don't want just one aura. You want, like, multiple. So, you know, like, Drow and then the Ventral Spirit, or Drow Beastmaster, or, you know, any other pairing that you can think of, and that's what makes it kind of hit that critical mass at the 25 to 30 minute mark like we saw in the last game. I think they won it, like, what, 28 minutes?
29 minutes. It was 29 minutes.
So here, it's a little bit different. Clearly, VG Gaming Reborn still have the chance to do some early sieges. If you have a Terrorblade on your team, you can expect the offlane tower to die within the first, like, 10 minutes, sometimes even sooner. But EHome, they have the mid-game burst. They have a decent amount of control already. I'm assuming this is just going to be an old chicken Timbersaw for two games in a row.
Wyvern.
I like this, actually.
I guess it helps protect you from the beatdown of a Terrorblade.
That's exactly the thing. So, you know, sometimes we see Beast, sometimes we see Brood, sometimes we see, you know, any hero that adds to the push. The nice thing about Winter Wyvern is it's good deep push. Winter's Curse is great against high physical DPS compositions because you just kill a hero inside of the curse. And then the rest of the team is like, okay, do we fight this or do we back? So I think on top of all those things, having the Cold Embrace, making sure that when Reflection is out, you're not just going to get a free kill. It's a great defensive and offensive pick against what Vici Gaming Reborn have fielded here. And for the second game in a row, we are going to see the Mikasa Storm Spirit. Now, his laning phase is going to be more or less the same, except he doesn't have the access to the Precision Aura because, you know, Joe hasn't been picked. So it's going to be a little bit harder. But at the same time, EHome, they actually don't have quite as potent of roamers unless they decide to go pick Tusk again, which I don't know if they'll do considering they already have a Kunkka.
Yeah, that's going to be unlikely. Yeah, because we're expecting to see the two supports, Wyvern and Kunkka. Still looking for that offlane at EHome, we'd imagine. It will be an offlane Tibbersaw, won't it? Because you probably expect the old chicken play the Mirana.
It could be safe lane Mirana still.
I guess it could be. I think they did do this because there was a game where they picked the Timber. Oh.
Oh. I like it. I like it a lot.
It's good with the
but
storm.
But this is actually funny because EHome did this earlier on.
They're taking this
from EHome.
Was it EHome that picked the Omni Knight before?
Yeah, we cast the game, didn't we?
No, it was ROTK's team that played it.
Are you sure? No, it was definitely Animal. It was definitely Ehome. Maybe it was Lumina who cast
okay,
it.
Okay, you must because I was gonna say I've casted it. The only game I casted with Omni Knight was when RTK took it to the offlane.
Because they had they had Lanham jungle the Omni Knight.
Yeah, I didn't see that.
And then there was a midstorm. So yeah, this is taking a bit of a note from that lineup. But yeah, looks like it is going to be the safe lane Timbersaw from Ehome. So good call on that. It's going to be the mid Morana.
Well, as I said last time they picked Ice, they I guess with the Doom though. Yeah, like he still went to the offlane with it, and then they put old 11 on a safe lane.
Okay.
So I guess it depends how they want to roll it, but yeah. Ice does love playing the hero, and
I think that in terms of kill potential, putting the Morana mid is probably better.
Okay.
Because then you have like an arrow after the X torrent coming.
Yeah. Oh yeah, definitely. Like Ice won't go mid with it for sure. Yeah. It's just a question of which lane he goes to on the side. I'm gonna be super surprised if he goes mid, but yeah, old chicken will play the mid Morana.
The Doom pick from Ehome, I think, is pretty solid. You throw it out onto the storm. Regardless of whether or not you get repelled, you can't do anything. So you can't,
I guess
can't have that teamfight influence.
There.
Same thing with N's Terrorblade. So you're hoping to win the engagement in the Doom time. And then, you know, it's like, what, 15 seconds, I think it is, at every level? Something like that?
All right. Double check. Yeah. Aegis Snatch. Nah, let's go by the odds. Play with highest total magical or pure damage done 10 minutes.
Magic or pure damage. I would probably say Storm.
Not even the Morana with the Starfalls? I guess 10 minutes is early.
Oh yeah, Old Chicken's mid, yeah. I think Old Chicken might be the choice.
Least deaths, Timber. No. Terrorblade.
Yeah, Terrorblade.
Highest magical in the end of the game. That's got to be Timbersaw. End of the game.
I'm okay with that.
Or maybe still the Morana. I think you are.
I think Ice
might. We'll go with Ice. It's a bit of a crazy man.
But that would also kind of insinuate that Ehome are going to win.
Yeah. I guess it would. But which obviously can definitely be the case here. Oh, DDC. Flirting with the arrows of Ehome. Hovering around it. They're not going to be able to find themselves the connection that they need to kick something off. So, return to lane for them. BGR as well. They'll look to secure themselves Aryan of sorts. Yang at the moment on the top. And it looks like... we'll see if Mikasa and DDC do go for this. So no, they're actually just going to head top and take the room from the top. But they don't want to go for a fight against Ehome's lineup at the start, by the looks of it.
I actually kind of think that VGR have the better lineup here. The battle
begins. Okay.
Even with the Winter Wyvern and the TB, the Doom, they have a lot of deep push and control on the side of Ehome. But I think that having an Omni Knight is just such a deterrent for what Ehome's game plan is, which is trying to cause some havoc in the laning phase. You know, you can't let Mikasa get a good start on Storm. And last game, even though he didn't have an ideal game, he still managed to have a pretty big impact. And I think that kind of is an issue here for Ehome in the second game. You know, imagine he gets like a decent Orca timing, then all of a sudden you're going to have to worry about a repelled Storm like balling into the front line and just causing a lot of problems. So I'm hoping that Ehome can manage to do something in the early game with her Kunkka, especially to try to pressure a bit here. But the way that VGR have laned it, it's a dual offlane.
Yep.
They have the Terrorblade versus the Timbersaw, and then the Winter Wyvern, which I clearly have to favor VGR's lineup in this lane. And then it's going to be the Slardar farming bottom lane with the support of an FY jungle Omni Knight, which, again, this is completely taken from Ehome.
Yeah, I was going to say, as you said, you're coming into this. You pointed that out.
I wonder if they'll lose to their own strategy. That would be interesting.
I mean, Jungle Omni, it's a good thing. Why does it work? Is it just because...
It's because more often than not nowadays when you're drafting, you only pick one hero who has a tendency to rotate. And by having a hero who's jungling all the time, who's very dependent on levels, you're guaranteeing that you're getting some kind of value out of it instead of just having a support that might have to pull and soak EXP that way, which, to be honest, pulling still gives the offlane a lot of experience if you're not doing, you know, doing the pulls properly. And sometimes the offlane can even contest the lane when you're doing a pull, which is even worse. So a jungler is just somebody that usually can't be punished that hard if there's only one roamer.
In the mid lane at the moment, Mikasa, again, liking in the game one, he's having a great time mid. You know, he's double the CS of Old Chicken's Morana. It's a good lane for him at the moment. But we may see that turn as Old Lanham. He's coming around. He's only got the level 1 Torrent. So he's got to hope that it hits. If it does, he can find the arrow set up. They do have a chance of finding a kill.
See him go for it now. He's going to miss the torrent, so immediately unable to do anything else. He will have another torrent as he has got an arcane rune. We'll see if he's able to use that to catch Mikasa out. He's playing around with it. Ooh, just on the edge. Not just going to connect there. So Mikasa, he'll be fine. And
he's actually owning mid. Like,
yeah, as I said, yeah, the CS is... I mean, it's the same story as last game. He just played the Storm mid absolutely beautifully.
Yeah. I mean, truthfully, the Mirana does have a pretty big base damage deficit, so it's kind of understandable.
Oh, he's in trouble now. Torrent's connected. Pots of Fairy Fire. The arrow connects. Mikasa, can he play his way out of this one? No, he can't. So, I mean, that's the power of the Kunkka, really. Just sit around the lane, spam out Torrent. Once you get a connection, you get yourself the kill.
Yeah, and that's why we kind of assume that the Mirana would be mid. Just better kill potential. That Star Storm arrow follow-up onto the X-Torrent is just a little bit too strong here. FY, unfortunately, not in a position to be able to help.
Oh, Levin. He's potentially in trouble here. Yep, and turning up. Starts to get a couple of clicks in. Yang has actually got no points in the sprint.
Yeah, I was going to say, he doesn't have any sprint at all. He just hits level 4, though.
Now he's got the sprint. But at this point, yeah, sprint and a level 1. So he's level 2 crush, but still not going to be enough. Lanham could be in trouble, though. He's come down deep. Yeah. Let's see him play his way out of this one. And he actually might be able to. Yep, they don't have a Pony Glimpse. Okay, so. The skill builds of VGR are kind of playing against them there. They just don't have the means to deal, to take down either old Levin or old Lanham.
I mean, they just literally walked it off. They just ran away, and that was fine. But that's kind of be expected, I think, of VGR's lineup. They don't really start to come online until, you know, the Storm hits 6. You want Mikasa to get that Ball Lightning. You want the use of the Repel and the Purification during fights to ensure that you can keep your Initiator alive.
And Mikasa getting ganked again. He's in so much trouble.
He is
so much trouble.
See you later.
Yeah. It's these ganks as well. It's just the old Lanham Kunkka that's doing so much. Each and every time, an X Mark and a Torrent. And you can kill the Storm as much as you want before he hits level 6. Even when he hits level 6, he's got to try and play around the X Marks, and that's not going to be easy in itself.
Well, they learned their lesson from the first game.
Yeah.
You can't just let the Storm have a 1v1 matchup.
You really can't.
So I think that EHOME are adapting properly. They've even gone as far as to rotate the lanes, even though, granted, it's like the same hero matchups. They're just in different places now. Kind of still have to favor VGR, though, in that regard, as Ice is down here with the 3 points into reactive armor. He just does not care about anything.
And still no control, no points in Glimpse, so they can't even do anything to in terms of dreaming of killing Ice. Top lane, Yang. He's headed up here, as you said, reacting to the rotations. Old chicken. Halfway through 5, a little bit ahead of the XP of this Mikasa Storm, thanks to the pickoffs they've had. And yeah, Ice. He can just afford to play so aggressively here. And well, top lane, all right.
Yang going down.
Yeah, old Lanham, again with the X marks, controlling the Slardar. And the Kunkka is, I mean, you can see why they pick it up first, Ethan.
They love this hero.
Yeah.
And they are extremely good with it. In some regards, I almost think it's worth respect banning. Like, maybe not in the first phase, but the second phase for sure. And gets solo killed by Ice. What? How do you let this happen? All right, EHOME are just... They are going ham in the first 10 minutes of the game. Like, this is just non-stop aggression. And with a very big misplay there. Of course, he's not level 6, so he doesn't have access to the Sunder. Giving Ice a kill. Timbersaw is almost level 7 at 6 minutes in.
I mean, FY, yeah. He's got to repel himself. Ice just...
He's going to keep chasing. He does not care. He has a mango, too.
He's going to find it.
He's dead.
Ice, ladies and gentlemen.
I think the only way he lives there is if he pops repel, uses the clarity to give himself mana for a TP, because FY had a clarity on him.
And we're going to
see
well.
Doom.
Yeah,
oh,
Doom.
Man.
Yang's in trouble as well, and EHOME, they are hitting back hard in game 2.
Jesus. It is a catastrophe of a laning phase here from VGR.
Ice is trying to play around the Terror Blade down bottom. He's got Arcane's back off cooldown in a few seconds as well, so he'll start to get himself back into fighting shape. Mikasa coming in with a rotation. He puts in Vortex, so we'll see if they have the control. And Ice. Tim chains himself up to the sideline. Moonlight's there as well. Do they have detection? The answer is no. And even if they did, I don't know if they would have been able to control him. Ice is just too damn scary at this stage of the game.
Reactive armor is way too strong at this stage. There's just not enough magical damage to kill the Timber.
Oh, they glimpse him, but he's X-marked himself. Oh, the outplay from old Lanham and now EHOME. They're going to try and come in, see if they get anything. They won't, but pretty good counter there to the glimpse. You've got an X-marked yourself.
Dude, that was so next level, actually. Lanham is some kind of Kunkka player for sure. Might be dead, though.
Well, see if he's got any kind of backup. Yeah, they don't have enough for a Golden Embracer. Yeah, Mikasa zips in. And with the purification, the burst is enough. VGR finding themselves the first kill onto the board for themselves. 1-6 now. But overall, this opening part of the game, it's certainly going into the hands of Ehime.
I mean, to be fair, even though Ehime are getting a lot of these kills, FY on the Omni Knight still has Arcane, still level 5 at, you know, 8 minutes. It's not too bad. I think that they have a couple of ways to make their way back into the game. DDC is also being farm priority in the top lane. So he's going to get that Static Storm going as soon as humanly possible. And then he still have the Slardar. He's level 5. He hasn't really had the best game, but he's also been rotating around. So Yang might be able to make some kind of recovery here as well. As long as they can take a couple of good engagements. But he might just be dying here to Ice Ice Ice, who is Arrow.
Chicken leaps in. Starfall, there's the heal.
Nice heal.
FYA with the backup just as it was needed.
He was definitely dead there if he didn't get healed.
What's this mid? Old Lana. Playing around Mikasa. Mikasa, he can't go for this. And Ice 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 will take the town. More money into the pocket of Ice Ice Ice. With the Sol Ring done as well, he's going to have enough mana to play around a little bit more. It's a scary opening for VGR. As you said, they are still finding relatively good item progress on the heroes as a whole. But Terra Blade, see how he's doing on net worth as we switch over to the tab. He's fallen behind. And you've got a Doom and Timbersaw at the top. I mean, this is scary at this stage of the game. I'll try for a bit of action mid. Leaping away, Old Chicken keeping himself safe. And Ice Ice Ice, I mean, it's kind of like that Brood role. You know, he just sits in this lane. And you can't do anything about it at this stage.
Yeah. I mean, it's one of those heroes, Timbersaw, where you get to a certain point, you have the 4 points into reactive, that you have to wait until core items start coming up before you can really even look to kill him. You kind of just have to ignore his existence for a while. And that can be annoying for some lineups, but you can still go for other kills.
That's the world's mid, Mikasa. He's the next target for Ehime. Mikasa already backing up. He's coming close again. They've got the X mark to lead in. Into the torrent. He will zip at the same time the X mark recall was going to be there. So able to juke that out. Now coming in from the side. Can VGR do anything in response? Looking for Fenrir, but he caught embraces himself. The metamorphosis ain't going to do nothing to him. Purification that will then. Fenrir falling low. They'll find themselves one. VGR. They do need to find themselves a little bit more, really, though. TPs are coming through. Old 11's got a Doom available. Mikasa zip-zapping forward. Turning around, thinking about a Doom. Actually not going to get the chance to get it off with the Amplify. The control from Yang with the Crush. They'll find themselves a second kill for Terrorblade. Moving in for more. Old Chicken leaps away. Oh, he doesn't quite get himself up the cliff. Looks like it won't matter, though. Glimpse won't be able to reach him. And in fact, it was already, yeah, it was still on cooldown. But VGR, they do find themselves a favorable fight. You know, they get themselves, well, it was a couple. And Ehime finding nothing in return, though.
Well, that's a bit of a little bit of hopeful engagement,
yes.
I suppose, for VGR, because Ehome were kind of running at them during the laning phase and pretty much getting all the better engagements. And on top of that, like, the Doom has Midas. He's level almost 9 at 11 minutes in. Like, he is incredibly farmed, old 11. I think the Doom is probably going to be the trump card here from Ehome to make sure that they can stay ahead. Because as we already talked about, even if you have a repel on target, you just Doom them. And it doesn't really... Like, it counteracts the repel and that the Storm still won't be able to really do anything in the fight.
Oh, nice glimpse catch from DDC here onto Old Chicken. And FY moving in. It's actually not going to be able to get the purification bomb off, still on cooldown. And wow, that's unfortunate for VGR there.
Did he heal the creep wave, FY? Because I think his purification was on cooldown.
It was on cooldown, yeah.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure he healed the creeps. A little bit of a misplay there. Could have been a kill.
Yeah, not killing Old Chicken there with the commitment of the Static Storm. That's... A bit painful here for VGR. Ehome still in a position. Oh, hello, DDC. Well, trying to walk in at the same time. Mikasa making a go for it onto Old Lanham. Immediately the turnaround behind the tower. DDC will get taken down. Old 11. So that's the Doom available and walk across. Mikasa trying to zip away. Will be able to get himself just back up to the high ground in time. But again, it's Ehome finding a kill. Still a bit of duration of Moonlight Shadow here. They've got to be careful, VGR. There, indeed. They're backing right up. Immediately away. Mid lane. Old Chicken jumps in. FY try for the deny. He's not going to get it. Top lane, Ice 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 just continues to farm, and he will indeed have a very good time on the Bloodstone this game at this pace.
Avicii are still managing to inch their way back in here. It's not like a huge swing or anything like that, but as soon as the Storm finishes his first item, and they can start going in with Repel, maybe they can play around the Doom a little bit. look for some good engagements. So we're going to see FY just doing the casual run at Winter Wyvern play. But yeah, all things considered, Ehome's still a little bit ahead here. Still waiting for VGR to kind of hit this mid-game peak where they're going to have the Terrorblade, having that level 4 Metamorphosis, a couple of Illusions, you know, stand behind them, have the Storm threatening the Initiation, and then start to push some towers, because right now, they've lost all their Tier 1s, and Ehome haven't lost a tower. And it's not even like a tower is low. It's like all their towers are almost at 100% life.
Yeah. Certainly a worry indeed for the side of VGR. Yang could be in trouble here. No, okay, he's got FY with him. He's going to be fine. Ehome, they're bringing the full team down here. Apart from Isosize remaining top. In fact, he's going to go mid and clear out that push. Arrow. Not going to find anyone. Isosize, as we talk about, still having so much space, so much farm on this Timbersaw. It's absolutely terrifying. Top of the board. VGR, they want to punish it. They're smoking up. They are going to look for a kill on Isosize. Let's see how this one plays off. Already with the lead in, zips out, Mikasa grabs Isosize, bringing him in with the Amplify, the nuke damage, the burst, it's a lot, is it enough? Yes it is. They'll take down Timber, a big kill here for the side of VGR, as Timber was having a pretty free game at the moment.
Oh, they want to go. They have a smoked Doom, Winter Wyvern, and Morana around here. Looks like they're going to think better of it and not decide to initiate, but...
What does Doom get this game? Does he get the Blink or the Shadow Blade? What's better for him closing the gap?
It's kind of hard to say. I would think Blink is probably best. Because you kind of want to find the Omni Knight or the Storm in the engagement. If you can get the Doom off onto one of them, I think you can just kind of run after him at that point. So we'll see. The other option is going for like this tanky frontline. You know, we've seen a lot of Crimson Guard in the past, seen like BKBs and Shivas and whatnot, just to make sure you can just cause a lot of ruckus and have the enemy team focus you, which I think is also a valid idea. But personally, if it were me, I would probably go for Blink.
Okay. Top lane all 11. He's looking for the wraparound onto Yang. Yang could be in trouble. Yeah, the Doom's going to be successful. Yang did get off the sprint in time. Of course, at the same time, that's going to mean he's just going to take increased damage. Into the tree line he goes.
Arrow.
The arrow. Oh, it's going to connect. And Yang, he's a goner.
That was really nicely placed there from Old Chicken. But yeah, we'll see. He is kind of pooling his money. He's sitting on top of 2,600 gold, so I assume if he was going to buy Blink, he would have bought it already. Shadowblade is a pretty scary item to play against, though, when you have a Doom, because, you know, innately, Storm and Terrorblade don't really want to be together that much unless they're pushing. So you want to play, like, this split-pushing slash farm game. And if there's a Shadowblade Doom on the opposition, you just feel very scared to go to lane in general, because as soon as you see that item, you're like, oh, well, I could get solo killed, and I don't really want that. So I'm just not going to farm, and we're going to try to 5-man. Maybe the 5-man doesn't work, and then Ehome win a fight, and the game becomes even harder for VGR, but... We will see soon.
There's no reason for him to go for BKB up first this game, is there?
I mean, BKB is definitely good.
Yeah.
But maybe not as a first item.
Bottom lane, Mikasa. He's coming out. He's found old Lanham. At the same time, Isosize is there as well. Mikasa, yeah. He's not going to go for any kind of play here. He needs to be careful. He can't do anything about the Timber on his own. Needs a plus one at least.
Not Curious Knight.
Well, there we have it. Should have clicked yes. I should have clicked yes. Oh wait, no, there wasn't. It was Aegis Snatch. We're fine. We're good.
Yeah, they even have that Morana like 800 gold away from Aghanim's, and it's only 16 minutes in. Ehome seemed to be just ramping up a little bit faster.
Isosize. Already putting the pressure onto this tier 2. Ehome coming through as well. See how they slow this down. Off to the gold, he did actually build up. He's still just going to pick up the Blink Dagger. He's got a bit of gold sitting up on top of that as well. VGR already putting themselves in position for the defense here. Mikasa is questioning how he wants to jump in on this one. Old Lanham moving in as well. They're under the cover of Moonlight Shadow. Arrow to Fly. Flies past. Not going to connect onto anyone. And Ehome actually backing up a little bit. Still keeping Isosize on the front. It's going to be an attempt on a wraparound from VGR with the smoke. Who can they catch? Isosize. Oh, it's actually going to come into the middle of Thistle. But at the same time, VGR, they're not biting. We're not jumping on him. They'll actually jump. Okay, there we have it. But the old 11 comes in with a Doom onto the Storm Spray. It's going to limit the effectiveness of VGR this fight. GA comes out, but IsoSize, he's got the Magical Burst and E-Home. They're forcing VGR back. This was not the opening that they were looking for. Yang getting caught up by the Chakram, the Timber Chain across. Mikasa still falling low. The Sunder. IsoSize bursts out with the Cold Embrace. Coming out in time from Fenrir. They're going to keep IsoSize alive. Mikasa having to zip himself back to base. They do end up losing the Wyvern, but still, nonetheless, E-Home chopping across for more. Who's IsoSize going to go for? He's got DDC in his sights, chops him down with the Timber Chain. It's 2-for-1 at the moment still. They're trying to fight back into this. They're looking for FY, tries to hide in the tree lines. It's not going to work. The combo there, controlling Yan, IsoSize coming across, chops him down as well. They're found for Mikasa, the last man standing, and he himself having to get back to base. Eon get the tower, and they take the team fight as well, 4-to-1.
Very impressive team fight there for Mihom. And a very clutch Cold Embrace there for Fenrir, much saving IsoSize. If he died there, I think that E-Home most likely lose that fight just because the Timber lost all his health and the Terrorblade went to full. So the fact that...
Yeah, it was great Sunder.
Yeah, he got kind of bursted back down. So it was very unfortunate for VGR if they weren't able to really secure that fight. And they're kind of just lacking from damage problems. The fight started off by, you know, the Storm getting doomed. We talked about it during the draft, how hard it is for Mikasa to play around that. And there's even a Purge creep eating on the Doom right now, so he can just go for a Dispel if he wants to.
Oh, FY, poor lad.
See you later. Yeah, that was an insane amount of damage. So, Aghanim showcased here now on Old Chicken.
Yep.
E-Home seem to be kind of firing on all cylinders. Everything is going well for them. They can keep applying pressure here. The only downside is their team is pretty mediocre at taking Roshan.
Yeah, that's true, yeah. They really don't have the right click. It's all about the jump and the burst. But at the same time, well, I guess, yeah, that affects the pie ground push as well. It, as you mentioned earlier, it's just not going to be the quickest. We'll see how they play it out at E-Home. Let's have a look at the graph. It is it's a fairly sizable lead indeed. 19 minutes in, and it's coming up to 12k lead. That was also a quick pause. Mikasa. See what's up with him. 2.3k. He's still managing to keep up the farm, relative to his team at least, but actually overall, it is just... The cause of E-Home towering ahead of that of VGR.
Yeah. They have a pretty sizable lead right now.
He's got Botstone as well. So Bots and a 16 Bloodstone charge, Timbersaw. At this point.
I think the Doom just makes it so hard for VGR to do what they want with their lineup. Because normally you pick Omni Knight and it's like, okay, we can make sure a core doesn't die during a team fight. But if they just get doomed, it doesn't matter if they're repelled because they can't use any of their abilities. So Mikasa Storm is just getting totally trumped by the Doom. And every single fight, all Old 11 has to do is blink in and then Doom him. And then the fight is just, they're down a hero. Storm suffers from Doom probably more than most other heroes in Dota.
Yeah. I mean, we saw in the last fight, yeah, just Doom and the Mikasa Storm. And suddenly, you know, a lot of the side of VGR's firepower is diminished. VGR. Let's see who the player's going to be next. Of course, this is all being spotted out by E-Home's warding. They know what's up. They know they're coming around. And in fact, they may look to try and take a fight. Mikasa, quick on the fingers. Out with the zip. Old Lanham, is he going to head up to High Ground to look for this one? They're thinking about it. They have the wall for the sidelines. Old Lanham. Maybe looking for a potential wraparound. That's not going to be the case. VGR keeping their distance to the west. Roshan, of course, still there, but as you said, neither team really with the quickest potential. Oh, I should work to be, but VGR can. But at the same time, they don't really want to look for a fight around the pit at this stage.
Yep.
But if they are able to find a few kills, find a good team fight, they can get themselves in with the Metamorphosis and the Amplify and take it down relatively quickly.
Yeah, but E-Home are not looking to kind of draw this game out. They really want to just take the fights.
And here's the Moonlight. See what they can find. Ready for the wraparound from behind it. Okay, the scan. That's going to mean they drop the sentry. It's a good scan, but at the same time, the Doom. It comes in onto Mikasa. He gets healed up by the Purification Repel. Will buy him some time. At the sidelines, though, they've already lost the Slaughter. They'll move in onto FY. Winter's Curse holding the man back, making sure there's no escape or save coming out from the Omni Knight. He'll heal himself. IsoSize, he'll miss the Timber Chain. He won't miss the Chakram. And of course, Old Lanham never misses the Torrent. E-Home again with a good wraparound Moonlight Shadow. Even though VGR, they did, you know, they managed to get a successful scan, immediately dropping the sentry, but they just couldn't react in time to the fighting power of E-Home. And now double blinks picked up for both Old Lanham and Old Chicken.
God, this is This is so hard for VGR. I think that picking the Omni Knight, EHOME have been the team who were running this from the get-go.
Yep.
It's like they understand the hero much more than VGR do. And the fact that when you pick Omni, you know the hero can't rotate. It's a greedy pick. You can almost always counter-pick Doom. Because the Doom functions as the same as the Omni Knight during the early game, except that his ultimate is just a complete hard counter to everything that Omni does. So I think that EHOME maybe just had a slight outdraft on the last pick, and VGR probably thought that it was going to be fine because they could just repel the hero and go in, but this is just an oversight, I think, from VGR not banning out the Doom, and that they are paying for it so heavily because Mikasa has yet to been able to do a single thing during this game.
Setting up in a Moonlight Shadow again, but this time EHOME, they're a little bit more spread out across the map.
Yeah.
So we'll see if Old Chicken wants to do anything on his own. They'll spot out Yang. Is he going to try and set up with some kind of arrow? See what he finds. Yang blinking across. Old 11 is around in the neighborhood, but Yang's already out of there. Okay, jumping in. Hits the arrow onto Mikasa, and Old Chicken finding the solo kills on a Storm. Beautiful arrow.
Yeah. Old Chicken is having a pretty standout performance, I would say. Second highest net worth here at 23 minutes in. Looking fairly solid. And everyone else in EHOME, there's just no pressure being applied. So look at how they're spread amongst the map. You know, two top, two mid, one bottom. They're being completely efficient around the map. Whereas VGR, they're grouped up. They're sitting by their tier 2. There's only one person, and that's Yang, who's kind of walking around looking for a potential engagement. It's just EHOME getting farther and farther ahead here.
And Yang needs to be careful himself. If all random gets a whiff of him, could be caught out by the X-Marks combination. Yank, yep. Still hiding up here, just giving the vision, giving the info, but okay, FY. Yeah, he's going to be fine. There's a glitch back onto Ice, and FY with the repel out and the runaway. He will escape. But nonetheless, EHOME, I'm going to come in hard with the push. Shiva's guard picked up by the Doom.
DC.
Okay.
Jeez, that damage.
Old Chicken just jumping in behind the boundaries.
At this point, it's kind of just like VGR relying on high ground. Look at the net worths, Owen. Like,
20k coming up over.
This is roughly like a 750 gold per minute advantage. Like, they're unbelievably far ahead, and they haven't even gone for Roshan. That's the scary part. Like, Roshan is up. EHOME are just pressuring all the lanes, and there is, like, no rebuttal from VGR whatsoever. The only person who has any sort of net worth is a Terrorblade. And Terrorblade is a great hero, don't get me wrong. But he can't...
Oh!
Oh, boy.
This is...
It's a Radiance TP.
Nah, it's a Rapier Andy, surely.
I mean, I don't think Rapier even does that much.
Dragon Lance Rapier, Metamorphosis, let's go.
Okay, truthfully, it could be a Rapier.
I think it could be a Rapier.
Yeah, it actually could be.
But I don't know.
It could
I guess
be like that. You remember when we
Radiance
were casting,
is good for pushing the lanes.
We were casting
the
Shanghai Winter Bracket Finals, and we were looking, and I was like, there's no way this is a Rapier, right? Ever since that point.
That?
Yeah, it was Envy Slark. Remember?
Oh, yeah. In
so ever since that moment, I never doubt the Rapier anymore, because
oh,
I was like...
Not. It's not Boo.
Okay, it's Radiance.
Boo.
But I was so sure in that moment that it wasn't a Rapier. And after the fact, I even found out that the rest of Secret didn't even think it was a Rapier. They were just like, wait, why did you buy a Rapier? But of course, it ended up working out. I don't know if the Radiance is really the play. Maybe he just wants to play more of like a split push game because he realizes that fighting is probably not going to work. And just delaying the game might be the better option.
I guess. I mean, the next fight is going to be, you know, Ice. With a BKB, there's no way you kill this Dimplesaw. There's literally no excuse for Ice to die at this stage.
Yeah, I think EHOME probably just continue what they have been doing. Oh, 11.
I tried to jump in for the Blink Doom onto Storm, but quick reactions there. Oh, Chicken's coming around. Let's see if he can hit an arrow. It's going to be hard. VGR just making a beeline straight back for the base.
Yeah, but this just goes to show how much of an advantage EHOME actually have when you can just bully somebody back like that. I mean, clearly right now VGR don't have any vision. So they're looking at the map and they say, okay, well, we don't know who's here. We can just assume that EHOME have some backup.
Oh, Old Chicken's going in deep. Old Chicken, here. Whoa.
Okay.
All right. Ice coming in to see if he can do any kind of cleanup. No, he gets glimpsed back. He's not going to be able to. Yeah, Old Chicken with a very low play there, jumping into four.
Yeah, I don't know about that. Maybe he thought his team was a bit closer.
I guess he maybe thought Ice was there to back him up around the corner, but yeah, that wasn't the case.
If Ehome had a team that could kill Roshan, I would say that they almost, you know, high ground at this point. Just given how much of a lead they have in regards to net worth. But their team is, I suppose with the Shivas on the Doom, they probably could kill it. They have arrow as well.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, realistically, what are VGR going to do? They can go for an Aegis Seal. Maybe, you know, Yang or Mikasa go inside of the pit and try to take it. But, and you know, in respect to straight up fighting, VGR cannot win a team fight. There is no way.
No.
So I guess the play is they sit inside the base and they hope that Ehome overextend, kind of similar to what Old Chicken was doing when he went towards middle lane. But yeah, I think they just Roshan. This is a pretty easy rush for them. Not like they'll kill it fast, but like we already said, VGR just can't fight them.
Bloodstone's now been finished on the Storm. You got Diffuser Blade being closed in on by Old Chicken. He really is item pickup after item pickup for the side of Ehome, and the arms just aren't coming out fast enough for VGR. The only one that's kind of up there is this Terrorblade with the Radiance. Actually picking him up himself up a gem as well, realizing the importance of having to deal with this Moonlight Shadow that Ehome have.
It's just nice for D-warding, because you can pop the mirror image, and you can send the illusion out and just do all the D-warding for you without any risk.
It's true. But just a lot of weight is on this Terrorblade to bring this game through and carry. A lot of pressure this time round for him.
Oh boy.
Did you see? We'll get the glimpse back onto one, but the torrent connects. In comes the boat. Choo choo.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
This is looking a little bit rough for VGR.
FY got his Midas.
I mean, look, 28 minute Midas. Okay, so when you see a Midas purchase like this, it's just because there's no other item that's gonna help you. Like, what do you buy? A mech? A force staff? Like, those items, maybe if the game is even, can help, and Mikasa is just going to get bodied here. There's no way he can get away.
Nope.
Oh.
Oh, Yang did get the... Oh!
That's a 5,600 gold courier.
What did I have on Andy? I don't think my courier hockey's wings. I've not mapped them.
I don't even think I have it bound.
Press the courier thing. Does it not?
It doesn't work for me.
You're such a scrub.
I mean, whatever it was fairly expensive. It had to have been a Murana item.
Yeah. Well, we'll find out in a couple of minutes.
Yeah.
But at the same time, I don't think it's that big of an issue, really, is it? I mean, Ehome would just be like,
It was a Hex. That's
we'll just wait. Yeah, Hex it was the Sheepstick.
Yeah, it cost 56.50.
That's Sheepstick, isn't it? Yeah, Sheepstick. Right. Oh, okay, well, Courier Revenge. Courier down.
Damn it, Owen.
They got it. The Courier Snipes have been real this game. But yeah, Ehome, they don't really care. Do they? It's like, whatever. We can't have a item for 2 minutes. Well, we'll just wait for 2 minutes. There's no pressure from them.
Yeah, it doesn't really matter at all. This FY just does the casual repel TP out, no big deal.
Goodbye.
I'm feeling like, you know, I'm looking towards the next game. Because I'm going to be real with you, Owen. VGR do not have a good shot at winning this game. Like, it is real tough. Ehome basically have to, like, they got a well dive almost to throw this advantage. I think that the last picks in these games have been very indicative of how it actually goes. Like the Doom versus the Omni Knight, it was just so heavily favored towards Ehome. Like they understood so well what the early game from VGR was going to be like and just knew that if we have Doom, he gets more out of the early game than an Omni. He counters the Omni. The Storm can't do anything either. It's like one hero counters two on VGR. That's just such a huge blow in regards to team composition that they were never really able to recover. And if VGR aren't playing from a huge advantage, their lineup just ceases to function. So I hope for the third game that, you know, VGR can kind of get a better draft. I think Ehome had a very, very good game plan. And they did in the first game as well. I think that one was more about execution than anything else.
That was just a TP out here. Did manage to get the second tower of VGR, tier 1 gone on the top lane. But still, I mean, this is, you know, never a good sign. You've got a Terror Blade, and you've only taken two tier 1s in 31 minutes.
Yep. I mean, truthfully, the Terrorblade is still very farmed. Like, he's got, you know, 17,500 net worth, and the Timbersaw is the only one on either team who's higher than him.
I mean, Ice. He is like amidst five of them here. Can they do anything to deal with him? Amplify, coming in with the control. Ice. He's got a BKB ready, and he'll pop it straight away. In fact, he turns. Forces VGR back, and that's a Metamorphosis out as well from End. Going around from the behind, old 11. Let's see who gets the jump on. He's looking for an opening. Jumps in Doom immediately onto End. No Sunder for you, sir. A purification comes out from FY. They're trying to keep the man alive, but End almost certainly still going to go down. In from the sidelines, Yang pots down the crush, but Lano's going to be able to arm it, toggle him off. Still the dives into the base potentially. Now Ehome will turn. They'll go for the easier kill, and they'll just look to finish off Yang. Playing around this man. Winter's Curse just to taunt him. Oh, okay. He may just taunt them. Okay, a bit of outplay here from Yang.
How did Ice get repelled? how did that happen?
Just use all your spells.
Just cast your spells on the... Oh, Mikasa eats the arrow to the face. Okay, well, checking Michael down. He gets both gems.
Oh, the BM Aquila drop.
No. He took the gem. That's why he dropped it, because he had Aegis.
I know. This is over, I think.
Yeah, I think it's pretty over.
This was a.
It looks like we'll be going from a best of five to a best of three
game.
Series.
Oh, FY. He was so beautiful. He's an angel. And he'll live on in heaven. Buybacks from FY. FY's back. It's the second coming. FY. Can he do it? Purification. FY. Nope.
They're diving pretty hard here.
They didn't get the tier 3.
Yeah, I know. That's what I'm saying. Like, they're diving really hard. And I'm not really sure why. They could even lose Ice.
Oh, Ice. If he goes down it, they may have got a little bit too cheeky for their own good. Just kidding. He homes back in.
Okay,
and,
there we go.
Yeah, there's the beatdown. End down. Yang down. Mikasa goes in for a tickle.
There's a buyback. The Disruptor has a buyback as well.
Goodbye, Mikasa. Oh, 11 jumps in. And then Mikasa ends up killing himself. The coach is disappointed in the team. End. Oh, no. He's got a Sunder. Oh, Shiva's got Static Storm down. Cold Embraces there. Old 11's fine. End. So that's the Sunder. Oh, hello. I'll take your health, sir. Reflection comes out. Mid-ball to his business as well, but the Torrent. All right, they have lost the Doom for that. Oh, Lanham, he's got the armor. Oh, glimpse back. Oh, hello, DDC. I'll just turn around and give you a bit of a slap.
Oh, dear.
Oh, goodbye. Death after death after death after death from the side of VGR. Oh, hello, FY. The god has returned. And he will watch people die on Ehome. Two have actually died on this. And they still don't find the tier 3. So it's a lot of playing around from Ehome. Obviously they're going to be fairly rich after that little bit of an escapade. Look at this. Straight diagonal line down.
Let's just say they have a lead.
More money in the bank here. More money in the bank. Any bigger? What are we buying anyway? So
everything.
28 bloodstone charges. Oh, and you just hit yourself an arrow. Yeah.
Wait, how do I?
Oh.
Yeah, this game is more or less over at this point. They're probably just talking about the next game. You know, what kind of strategy they want to run. We've seen some similar stuff from Ehome in both Game 1 and Game 2, but I would say in the second game, they just had the best possible reaction to the Omni-Knight pick in the Doom. That just crushed VGR. I think that pick alone, like, single-handedly won in the game. So to me, this is a bit of an outdraft, but... Looking forward, I don't think that VGR are going to let themselves fall into this trap again.
Nope.
And clearly they had a strong performance in the first match, so I'm guessing this is going to go the distance. You know, five games. I wouldn't be surprised.
You reckon? Yeah, VGR can pull that back and everyone win in the series.
I would not even be the least bit surprised if it went to five games. Okay. But right now it's like in excess of 25,000 gold, 25,000 experience in favor of Ehome. You know, they've all but just killed the throne, and they were diving like the tier 4s in the well instead of just, you know, killing the base.
FY.
There's even a defusal now on Murana, so much for the repel and the GA. Not really going to do much of anything now.
No.
But, you know, this is something that VGR can look at and be like, okay, We learned when we can pick Omni and when we can't pick Omni. And this is a perfect example of that situation. I think the only time you can get away with it is if you, like, 4th or 5th pick it, and you have both of the supports and the offlane already taken up by the enemy team. Because then, you know, Doom can do pretty much anything. He can support, he can offlane, he can mid. Like, it doesn't matter where he goes. So if you have, like, supports and offlane already picked, then the Doom becomes less likely because he wants to be in a position where he's not, like, a core role. He doesn't really want to be mid. He doesn't want to be safe lane. He needs to fill that gap between those roles where you can still get some semblance of farm, like play it as a 3, but not necessarily have to go to the offlane. And I think that was the oversight here from BGR in this game.
They're just hanging behind us at the moment, just seeing if anyone wants to try and jump on it. It's not going to be the case. So that's the problem. The Shiva's Reflection will come out from ends TV. Here we are, now getting a bit more damage down the tower, but that's obviously what we talked about. They just don't have the best tower taking lineup. And at this point, when they are in the position that they are.
But they're so far ahead. Yep. Like, it doesn't even matter that their team can't hit towers that well. Their Timber Saw has 355 CS and 24,000 net worth at 38 minutes. Like, he's like invulnerable.
Tessa playing around. And more for Sister Lucian's just flying in. Trying to keep them off the racks. Old Chicken jumps forward. He's got X mark, so he'll be brought back out. Oh, but the Yules! That's actually going to catch him out of place now. And the Static Storm down. Old Chicken with a cold embrace. The boat flies through. Slardar's down. GA from FY. They're looking to take down the metamorphosized TB, and they will with the Doom. And there we have. They've had enough VG Reborn. GG is called. And E-Home with a pretty hefty beat down there onto the side. There was little hope for VGR that game.
Yeah, I do genuinely feel like it was an outdraft.
Yep.
First going into the game, I liked the Doom pick. I thought there was a chance that VGR, if they did well in their lanes, they could snowball it. But as soon as there started to be like these fights where E-Home were just like taking two or three and only losing one and making favorable trades, it just became super apparent that BGR didn't have an answer for the Doom. Like, they need to kill that hero instantly. If the Doom doesn't get jumped and start the fight by him being dead, BGR have almost no chance, because Mikasa got Doomed, like, what, 3 or 4 times in a row? Every single engagement? He just can't do anything. Like, the whole purpose of picking Omni Knight is to enable a hero. And if your repel doesn't enable the Storm to go in, then it just doesn't matter what happens after that point, because the pick just is useless. So, again, E-Home showing a very good understanding of drafting, and I don't think that VGR will run the Omni Knight again unless they feel like they can get away with it or they ban Doom, one or the other. But solid performance, and it looks like we go from a best of 5 to a best of 3 as the series is tied up 1-1.
Absolutely. So don't go anywhere, ladies and gentlemen. Game 3 will be around the corner, and we'll see indeed if E-Home can continue this stride after a pretty scary showing from them here in Game 2. And VGR needed to pull it back. Maybe we'll see them come out with some kind of funky trap like they did in game one. Getting the Drow through again, if they can do that, they might just have a chance. But E-Home certainly outplaying them and outdrafting them, in your opinion, as you said, Andy, here in game 2. Game 3, around the corner. See you guys in a bizzle.